on. 3 quarters ago, we introduced the notion of the end of the great beta trade and the idea that the previous 5 years, which had been characterized by well above normal market returns with well below normal levels of volatility and dispersion, were about to change and be replaced by a period of more muted returns with much higher and sharper levels of volatility. That volatility was so sharp in the first quarter, many investors began to wonder whether or not difficult market conditions were telling us something about global economic conditions. Well, at least historically, these indicators have been poor forecasters of economic realities. For example, we've been in a U.S. earnings recession for a little bit here, and if I look back historically, that's a very poor forecaster of real U.S. economic recessions. Perhaps more importantly, it's a very poor forecaster of returns. During earnings recessions in the U.S., we've averaged 5.5% returns, 8% if we exclude the great financial crisis. So let's separate the macro from the market. At a macro level, for us, it's still moderate global growth, low levels of global inflation, and generally lots of accommodative policy throughout the world. But there are stories within the stories. China is a multidimensional story. However, at a high level, we still think China avoids a hard landing as its growth slows and it transitions to a services-based economy. However, we will be keeping a very close eye on the policy decisions that China is making along the way to try to safeguard that journey and its restructuring. In the U.S., it's much more straightforward. We just don't see a recession. We don't see it in new orders, we don't see it in jobs, we don't see it in income, and we don't see it in housing, all very important parts of the U.S. economy as we go forward. And as I use the U.S. to transition into the capital markets view, we've been talking about strength that we see in U.S. high yield. And after a volatile first quarter for high yield, as with much of the markets, returns were pretty strong. But driven more by an attractive coupon and falling U.S. yields, spreads, which were already elevated, got higher in the first part, but ended up where they started. Translation, still lots of opportunity in high yield. But keep in mind, this period reminds us more of 2002 than 2008. In other words, a more localized culprit in terms of the sell-off. Today, basics and energy. Not the broad-based sell-off we saw in 2008, which gives us even more opportunity to avoid the losers in generating strong overall high yield performance in our portfolio. Equities, on the other hand, may be more about finding the winners. And we've been trapped a little bit in a period of risk-on and risk-off trading as investors for some time. For example, last year, consumer cyclicals among the leaders. In the first quarter of this year, with difficult markets and falling yields, utilities lead the way. Look, it's important to probably remember that there's a difference between the cost of safety and the cost of quality. Historically, safety is very expensive today, where quality is cheaper. Probably the best way to do this is to compare dividend yielders against dividend growers in terms of price. And today, based on pricing and the way we see the markets, we clearly favor the latter. And by the way, you needn't sacrifice downside protection, as quality factors are pretty resilient as well. And speaking of downside protection, alternatives tend to be the poster children for downside protection, and during these sell-offs, they've done an admirable job. Another area where they can jump to the front today is in relative value capture. I talked about the opportunities in credit, for example. But this dispersion in returns amongst winners and losers mean we have the opportunity to go long and short as well to find that value. Look, I don't think it's any secret that over the coming years, we're all expecting much higher levels of volatility and more muted levels of returns. The path forward for us continues to be about focusing on strategies that generate more upside and better downside protection. And that's going to involve better balance, being highly active, and making good decisions as we move through the market cycle. As always, it's great to spend time with you, and we look forward to seeing you next quarter.